other, die for each other. We're cool for the summer. So, what's up, guys? So one of my friends did a video which was basically called Get to Know Me. It's kind of something I guess quite a few YouTubers do. You can tell how much I just really pay attention to social media fads, I guess it is. I don't know. So, basically, I just thought about it, and I wasn't challenged to do it. In fact, there's some things that I'm not challenged to do. I just kind of take a look at it and think, you know, maybe I should, you know, do something kind of interesting for my audience. And, yeah. So, for those of you I'll get to it in a minute. But yeah, this is going to be a get to know me sort of video for those of you that don't, you know, that want to get to know me better or don't know me, my fans, my closest subscribers, people that I talk to on a regular basis, don't really know about me or do know about me or just want to get to know me better, whatever. So, yeah, number one right off the bat, one of my subscribers slash people I'm subscribed to slash friends slash YouTubers, whatever, is my friend Carissa Rissa. You can go check out her channel. I will actually post a link in the description. Go check her out. She's kind of derp, but then again, we all love her anyway. But yeah, she's a good friend of mine, you know, personal friend, actually. You know, we live in the same area, so it's kind of like, you know, it's not like my friends that I have that are like, you know, 5,000, you know, 3,000 or 5,000 miles away from me. Jay McGowan, for instance. Love you, dude. You need to come to Cali sometime, because I can't afford the trip to Ireland or Scotland or wherever the fuck you live. I think it's Ireland, isn't it? Correct me if I'm wrong. Anyway, and sorry if I'm making, and I'm not trying to make a comparison between the two, because I know how Scottish people and Irish people get about that. But yeah, he's, and there, and that's another thing you ought to know about me straight up when it comes to friends and stuff like that. I have friends all over the place and connections all over the place. You know, I'm acquainted with Jason Unruh. I'm acquainted with Scottish Socialist. I'm actually had the satisfaction of getting to know Jay a little bit. Not really friends yet, maybe acquainted in a little bit with Jim Prophet. Would like to get to know him better. What was another person? SMG John. We don't really talk as much as we'd like because, you know, she, you know, that the individual is usually on YouTube more than they are Twitter, and that's usually how we used to communicate, but I'm barely on Twitter myself anymore, so... Yeah, but, you know, you can always still send me something because it'll pop up in my notifications anyway. Yeah, so, and then of course I know people that live in, like, Eastern Europe, people that live in the Philippines, people that live, you know, I have people that are all over the U.S., so, yeah. So I guess the second thing you may or may not know about me is the fact that I have friends scattered across the globe. I have connections and contacts scattered across the globe. You put your political views out there on YouTube, or just put a video out there on YouTube with any sort of opinion on anything, and you know, it's amazing the people that you can get connected with. So yeah, other things, you know, obvious things you may know about me, maybe not if you don't pay that close attention to me, is that I am very political. I am Marxist. I am communist, whatever you want to call me. At the same time, I don't let, or I try not to let, my ideology and my political views, I try not to let them define who I am. I try not to let them, I try not to basically let them govern my life and stuff like that, you know. It's like, yeah, I have certain political beliefs, but it's not like, you know, it's not like it's a goddamn religion. It's not like it's a lifestyle that I live by. It's just ideological principles that guide my political thinking. But other than that, no. And just in on that step in general, people always have misconceptions about socialism, about communism, but they typically tend to ignore the whole concepts of what the science behind these are, which is Marxism, Marxism-Leninism, Marxism-Leninism-Maoism, etc. And they typically just don't tend to realize these things. And then there's people that make horrible assumptions like socialists are Nazis and Nazis are socialists, which is complete BS. I've debunked that 1,000 times. Jason Unruh has debunked that 1,000 times. Scottish Socialists has debunked that a few times. It's just, you know, it's been debunked and it's been debated enough. And it's, yeah. So, yeah, very political, as you can kind of tell by some of the things that are up there. NorCal Corner, that's what I do. That's one of the things a lot of people don't know. Some people actually don't know about me, especially weirdly enough, people that are in my, within my actual circle, like my friends, my family, those are the people that don't really know that truly to the extent that, you know, what I do, and that's that I run my own, you know, my own web show, which is NorCal Corner. What I'm doing technically right now, that's NorCal Corner. But typically, yes, I'm talking about current events, political shit, sometimes religious shit, debunking that stuff. So, yeah, I'm, you know, I try to keep, because I like keeping up to date with that stuff. You know, I like doing what I do for a hobby and stuff like that. Might even turn it all into something major one day, but right now this is just something I do in my spare time. I'm not making money off of it, you know, so yeah. Basically, some of you may not know that, it's probably obvious if you're watching this video particularly, but I am a Giants fan. So, yeah. And the funny thing is that I am such a damn Giants fan that I actually wore my Giants shirts and jerseys and all kinds of other BS. I had Giant sunglasses. They broke recently, unfortunately. I have to look for a new pair. Probably won't find them until spring, but yeah, I had a pair of Giant sunglasses, a Giants ball cap. I had Giants jerseys, Giants shirts. Orange and black up the wazoo, man. And I wore that all down when I went to Los Angeles this past July. And I did get a lot of stares, and I just can't understand why. it was a hoot. And then that's another thing. I've gotten the chance to travel. And if you watch some of my videos, you've seen that, because I'm good at documenting shit most of the time. But Not the last one that I did. Not the last. Well, okay, that's a lie. To be honest, I document some shit okay if I think about it. But I also have horrible ADD, and that's another thing that some people don't know about me, is that I do have attention deficit disorder. And, you know, it's kind of why one of the things that's in the description box is attention deficient for the part of the motto, because I'm squirrely as all hell. I could literally be, you even see it in some of my videos, how I can be going straight and narrow, chugging along, all of a sudden we gotta take this little detour, then we're chugging along, we're taking another little detour, and eventually we get back to a main topic at hand, but you just gotta take that little trip with me every once in a while. And this is not just in videos, and it's not an act at all. That's literally the doofus that I am. My friends could even testify to that shit. Yeah, so that's something. But yeah, I have a bad attention deficit disorder. I suffer from clinical depression. I have anxiety. All things that some people think I should be medicated for. But I also live in California, and I'm not afraid to say that I am a pot smoker. I am a pothead. I do smoke. You know, I am a stoner. If you actually want to go to that far of an extreme, yes, I do smoke pot. I do inhale, and I don't really feel ashamed to say that. And anybody that wants to go ahead and demonize marijuana, go ahead, because I have plenty of shit to debunk you with. And this also, that's one of the biggest problems that brings me into contention a lot of times with my own family, because I have family members that like to argue with me, saying how dangerous it is, and it's this and that, or that there's medicinal value in it, but to have it recreationally is just silly, and blah, 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 and I understand their thinking, I don't necessarily understand their logic, because their logic is kind of, I'm not trying to be confrontational here, but their logic is kind of flawed. I still love them. They're my family. I've got to. And, and I do. I love my family, but ideologically and just on a lot of different, ideologically, whether it be on a certain issue, whether it be political or even religious, we tend not to agree on certain things. There is some things we can agree on, guns, for instance, but not a lot of other things, but I still love them anyway. And one thing you need to know about me is that I come from a family that is, and this is why my family is very conservative. My family has a lot of military veterans in it. My uncle served in 3 branches. My grandfather served Air Force. I have other family members that served in Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force. I don't know if we had anybody that served Coast Guard, but I know that we have, they're just, pretty much you name the branch, they were involved with it. And some of my family members have experimented with Agent Orange. Some of my family members actually were involved in the Vietnam War. I don't really want to talk about it in depth, but I will just mention it because it does kind of concern my ideological views, and I'm not going to say my position on it because it's obvious, but my family has contributed to forms of imperialism, and it's something that, I don't like to argue with them. I don't want to be confrontational with them and stuff like that. We have our differences of opinion, You know, I respect them for what they've done, you know, and, you know, because, let's be honest, that some of them didn't even have a choice. Some of these people were thrown into these sort of situations and basically just told the fucking fight. And, you know, they are put in dangerous situations. Some of them are disabled because of that. And so, yeah. So, yeah, I have military members in my family. I have friends that are in the military. You know, I live freaking near a military... I literally live in an area that is where the military base is the gateway to the Pacific. I mean, yeah, it's a very kind of... It's one of those counties. But, yeah. I will get to that in a minute. But let me... I mentioned about how I was a Giants fan. I am just, in general, a sports fan. I love the Giants for baseball. Ifs, ands, no ifs, ands, buts about it. No, I'm this or that. I'm this or that, too. No, I'm a straight down the middle San Francisco Giants fan. And a 100% Dodger hater. I don't got a problem with the A's. I grew up watching both teams, but to call myself a fan? No. I would call myself a... Yeah, I would just call myself a likely observer. I would just basically say that I'm a likable observer of the team. I don't have a problem with them. I don't hate them. I don't like them exactly, but they're a NorCal team, and every once in a while, you might see me walking down the street, you know, somewhere down the line, sporting an A's jersey. I don't really have a it's not that I, yeah, I'm, it's not that I'm a fan or that I'm not a fan, it's just, I'm an observer, I guess, but definitely die hard Giants, and in this playoff season, I am pulling for the Cubs, because I actually used to be a big fan of the Cubs, and, I just kind of, you know, I you know, again, grew up in the San Francisco Bay Area, so I rep orange and black, but because they aren't in the playoffs, I am gonna cheer on an old team that I used to be a fan of, you know, not bandwagoning, but I am gonna cheer on a team that I think, you know, does have a chance for it. And I'm also cheering on the Astros, just for the sake of it. I like underdogs, so whatever. But yeah, because I am a Giants fan, I do also am a fan of the Sacramento River Cats. I don't live too far from either city, so I like the Giants, and I like to go to ball games. And every once in a while, I might go catch a River Cats game, because Sacramento really ain't... San Francisco and Sacramento basically really ain't that far from me. I'm a football fan as well. I love the 49ers. I grew up watching them. You know, the Raiders, I don't really give two fucks about. I'm sorry if you're a Raiders fan, but I don't. But yeah, I am a 49ers fan, I am a but most of all, I am a diehard Chargers fan. Have been for many years now. I used to do Charger Nation things about how they did each week. I would basically post updates about that. God, most embarrassing bullshit that I still let people access. But yeah, that was when I was in high school, but I've been a diehard Chargers fan since, like, for at least 10 years. I love the Chargers, and I'm, yeah. And like I said, I also pull for the 49ers because they are my regional team. They are my NorCal team. I love them. I grew up watching them. In fact, the 49ers, I've been a fan of since I was 3 years old. I'm 24 now. That's a long time. And as you can see behind me, I also have Joe Montana, and from the Giants, I have Barry Bonds, because those are my two favorite. Joe Montana is my favorite football player. Personally, in my view, best quarterback in the that the NFL ever fucking had. And you can care to debate me on that if you wish. Barry Bonds, whatever you want to say about him, favorite baseball player of all time for me. I love him. I don't have a bad thing to say about him. You know, you can bring up the steroid scandal if you want, but I don't really care. It's a game. So, yeah, I love Barry Bonds. And I'm also a basketball fan. I rep the Kings up here for a reason. Again, NorCal Corner. I rep the Kings. I like the Kings. You know, never really said a bad word about them. But I also understand we're struggling. We've been struggling for a long time now. And, you know, I think eventually we'll get back to, you know, we'll get to a point where we need to be. But right now we're really we've been in a bad state. And, but my favorite, but like with baseball, like with football, my favorite team is the Lakers. And I know that the Lakers had a horrible friggin' couple seasons here, but I love the Lakers, and I will never stop liking the Lakers, and I will never stop liking the Kings. And I'm not a fan of the Golden State Warriors, but I still gotta give it up to those guys. You know, they brought home a lot of NorCal pride for my area. So, you know, may not be a fan, but I know what's what, and I know what's up, and I know and I gotta give a lot of respect to Golden State this year. They played a hell of a season, and I look forward to actually seeing what them and the Kings and the Lakers are all going to do this coming season. So, yeah. And, yeah. So, as far as sports go, that's kind of where I am. I also, you know, have Sac Hornets, the Sac State Hornets and the Sonoma State Seawolves, that are up here, because, you know, those are a couple options I'm looking at for colleges, for, like, transferring to universities and stuff like that to pursue my education. But it's also that they're NorCal teams. I love them. I also love Cal. They're my regional team. The UC Davis. But most of all, you can't see it because it's on the other wall, but I am a USC Trojans fan, thick and thin through it all, and that is my favorite college football team, my favorite college team, period. You know, well, okay, college football team. Baseball-wise, I really don't have one. As far as college goes, my favorite college basketball team, Pacific Tigers. I love University of the Pacific. I love, you know, I love going through Stockton. I love going to the areas around Stockton. Yeah, and if not exactly place, there's some places you definitely don't want to be at night. Let's put it that way. But if you ever do get the chance to go to Stockton, it's a beautiful little city. Inland city, basically. It has a little port that comes in from the sloughs and everything. It's basically where the Sacramento and San Joaquin rivers basically meet. It's beautiful. So yeah. What else is back here? I talked about the politics and stuff like that. My favorite, I have the V for Vendetta symbol up there. One, big inspiration. Two, love V for Vendetta. Favorite movie ever. My favorite book is 1984, in case you didn't know. Yeah, I love Lenin and I love Mao. Although personally, I think Mao's, the way he carried some things out, could have been implemented better. I believe in his thought process, though. I love his writings, everything else. Let's push this up a little bit. The that Berkeley repertoire thing, that was actually a Green Day poster. I did not get to go to see them perform their American Idiot thing, their American Idiot play or whatever it was at the repertoire, but a friend of mine did, and she got me that. So I absolutely am indebted to her because of that, and plus it just because of the way it's up there. Yeah, that just makes a great revolutionary symbol. More giants! Anyway, and then obviously behind me I've got my flags, like the NorCal Corner, NorCal. The other one is basically just a U.S. flag painted with, instead of the stars and stripes, with the Norse fire symbol, because that's kind of what I think America's turning into. And then, of course, above that is my California, original California bear flag, the California Republic flag, the original bear flag, when California actually was an independent nation. The other one is the old white with red Lone Star, and then, of course, the little, that little small California flag, which is technically our state flag, that's right up here. That actually came off of a candy wrapper. They actually make a California bear flag candy chocolate bar that I got in Old Town Sac. And by the way, if you're ever in Sacramento, stop through Old Town Sac. You know, there's a lot of great places there. Go to Joe's Crab Shack, right across the little yellow tower bridge there is Sacramento Rivercat Stadium, so go catch a game if you want. State Capitol's not that far from it. Yeah, lots of stuff to do. And in case you, one of the things that, again, like I said, 49ers fan, but one of the things you do not know is that I am really obsessed with California. I'm born in California, I'm raised in California, I was fucking born in Napa, so yeah. I used to drink, I don't anymore, but wine is life, frankly. So is tequila, that's what got me fucked up. yeah, I am obsessed with California. I believe California should be an independent nation. I believe myself to be a nationality, because we do have our own culture and everything else, so blah, 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 blah. I don't want to go into big details. Like I said, I don't drink anymore, but I have a California Republic shot glass. That's, again, how obsessed with California I am. And that's another thing that you need to know about me, and I'll actually show it here in a minute, get up to show you it in a minute. But I collect shot glasses. I may not drink, but I don't really collect, I never really collected shot glasses, because, you know, I wanted, you know, to take a shot out of 15 of them. But it's just like, no, I am just an avid fan collector of shot glasses. Some people collect stamps, some people collect old change and stuff like that, like old pennies. Some people collect old Playboys and comic books, that sort of crap. I collect shot glasses. That's the sort of nerd that I am. But let me show you that real quick. So yeah, like I said, I collect shot glasses. I came across three of these little bastards while shopping one day, and that was for St. Patty's Day. Why do I have three? I don't fucking know, but I do. Might give two of them away this year. I don't know. Again, I'm a 49ers. I'm a sports fan. I found this one time. It is a double skulled shot glass. Wonderful for Halloween. Kind of forgot I had that. I don't think anybody remembers what the hell Yukon Jack was, but this was actually one of my, this and this. This is just a plain one. But these were actually are more sentimental to me because these are actually my grandfather's old shot glasses, and my grandfather passed away 3 years ago around Christmas, so you know, I keep them for a reason. I used to have another one of these, and I broke when it broke as I was going out east. I had them wrapped all nice and stuff like that, because again, I took my shot glasses with me. That's how much of an idiot I am. But yes, an old this was the 2012 World Series champions thing. I think I bought this actually right before the Giants won the World Series last year too. And then I have a San Francisco Giants little old pin here that I don't know what to do with, along with the Fear the Beard, because if any of you remember the old Fear the Beard and where it actually originated, which was actually in San Francisco, not Boston, that was one of the biggest things that we had going for us, and I think that was going on in like 2010, was our Fear the Beard campaign. This one right here, fuck off, I'm drinking. Yeah. And most of these I get like at, you know, you can go get it like Spencer's and stuff like that. And one of these days I'm going to end up buying like all the rest of them when I actually have the chance. Like I said, I do smoke pot, and this is California, and you can actually find these sort of things all over California. I mean, we have smoke shops everywhere. It's like one of those things where it's like, it's like, they're becoming like Starbucks's. I can only imagine what's going to happen when we legalize shit. And that one. That one. And this is an old, I love Family Guy, so, yeah. And it also has the ingredients on the back for making what's called making a fudgy. Sounds appetizing, I know, when you consider it stewy in a diaper, but yeah, I don't know if you can read the bottom of it, but essentially it shows you what basically how to make these things and blah blah blah. So yeah, and then of course, like I said, the California one. I thought I had more, but they might be somewhere else. But anyway, yeah, that's pretty much it. Other things, though, that you might may or may not know about me. I used to be an atheist. I was actually born into a family that was kind of conflicted. My grandmother was baptized Lutheran, later became Methodist. My mom was born into that. I basically grew up agnostic. I became an atheist, and then I found Wicca, and the ideas of paganism and stuff like that. So I am a pagan, but I'm also a male witch. Have been October 29th will be the 1 year since I converted. And, I've basically just kind of learning as I go, learning at my own pace, practicing what I, practicing, these little things as I go, and, it's not something that you just dive into, and it's one of those things that I am quite, content with where I am because of this, and I am very proud of who I am. I'm proud of my decision. I have no regrets about my decision. Despite what people may say about me, this is who I am. So, yeah. I've pretty much talked about a lot of things going on, but, I don't, as much as I read a lot of news articles and post about politics, I really don't actually take the time to read much of a lot of things these days. But I do stuff for academic reasons. So one of the things I'm actually going to be doing, because I am taking philosophy this semester at my college, I'm a college student, is philosophy. And one thing that's in the philosophy book that I never got the chance to read was Plato's The Republic. And it's always something that I've wanted to read and something that I plan on reading. Actually, I'm going to start on it tomorrow. So it's something that I really like and enjoy. But yeah. And I like animals. I do like animals. I like, you know, I really don't have a preference, but I do own, I share a house with three cats, all of which basically give me the look of death all the time, including my familiar, which is my cat, who's about, she is gonna be 17 years old this coming year. She's just a little thing. She's the runt of the litter, and so that's my cat Gizmo for you. And then my grandmother has a fat golden cat, and then my mom has a fat gray and white cat who's not very bright and about as schizophrenic as freaking Gary Busey on bath salts in Florida. So, just little things. My favorite drink is Mountain Dew. I love Baja Blast. Favorite food, I love Mexican food. I love a lot of things Mexican. Mexican food, Mexican spices, Mexican soda, Mexican beer, Mexican liquor. You know, Mexican wine, Mexican women. Anyway, it's just one of the, I'm a little bit of a Mexicophile, I guess is what you could call it. Just like how I'm, when it comes to Soviet history, I'm kind of a bit of a Russophile. But I could prefer to think of myself as like a Sovophile or something. What else I really could say about me. Other than that, I'm just an extrovert. I used to be an introvert, and I am an introvert in some areas, and I'm an introvert when it comes, and I definitely was an introvert when I was in high school, but I am just an extrovert. I make friends easy. I never claimed to be, nor do I still to this day claim to be, one of those popular people by any means, because, you know, that sounds conceited, but, you know, I do make friends easily, and I do have a lot, and I have a large circle of people around me, and a lot of close people around me, and, so it's really kind of interesting, and it's funny how I talk about friends, too, because I've got friends in all, like I say, I have friends in all kinds of places. You know, I have friends that are gay, I have friends that are straight, I have friends that are trans, and I have friends that are not. I have friends that are Muslim, and I have friends that are, you know, Christian, and I have friends that are atheists. It's just a wide array of people, and I even have friends that are conservatives, and friends that are liberal, and friends who are socialist, and stuff like that. So, you know, I have a wide array of people that I keep in contact with. And, you know, I have friends in just about every freaking background you want. In fact, if you actually laid it out, I am probably one of the very few crackers in the box, so to speak, because most of my friends are either African American, Latino, Asian, Arab, Indian, and I think only a few white people. I think I have maybe, like, maybe, no, I have more than that, but, I do, at least as of recently, I've gained more white friends, but I like the diversity that I have. I love the diversity of what I've come to have in my circles, and it's really allowed me to probably have that wide array of knowledge that I have on the world. So, yeah. But that is about all I can really think of. I think I've pretty much talked a lot about it. The only thing I could really think of is, like, as far as gaming and stuff like that. No, I'm not much of a gamer anymore. I used to be. Still play a few games. Can't wait for Fallout 4. But other than that, I'm really not a big gamer as much as I used to be. I'm more concerned myself with more trivial matters, and that's kind of it. And I mentioned how I'm a college student, and looking to pursue my education further. But, yeah. Oh, and I have one little annoying toddler sister. And I love the little squirt to death, but she drives me nuts on a daily basis. But other than all that, that's about it for me. Oh, and by the way, I'm single as of right now, so ladies, if you just want to know, yeah, I'm single as of right now. But yeah, that is about it. I'm Nor Kelnick, leader of the revolutionist movement. And this is kind of Get to Know Me. Later.